Can you play us a snippet of one of your new songs?
Oh.
And a snippet could be 5 seconds. It could be 0.3.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You feeling gutsy? Okay. You're up for it?
Scared.
Okay, here we go. It's Will Manning. It's Capital Breakfast. It is Friday morning. We've reached the end of the week. And let's go out on a high, guys. Olivia Rodrigo. Hello.
Hey.
Hi.
Thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it.
Hey, thanks so much for being here. We've spoken a few times on Zoom and stuff. But here we are in real life, meeting for the first time.
It's incredible. I love it.
Is it special for you as it is for me?
Oh my God, so special.
Yeah.
So much better than seeing you on Zoom. I'm so happy to see you in the flesh.
Yeah. How long are you in the UK for?
I'm just here for one more day, but okay. I've been here for like the past week and it's been so great. I went to a football game. I like saw all the sights. I went to high tea. I feel like...
High tea? What's that?
Is that what it's called? Oh no,
I don't know.
I'm scared.
What is it? What did you do?
It's like kind of like fancy. You have like...
Afternoon tea.
Yeah, afternoon tea. Yeah, sorry.
Did you like it?
That's what it's called. Loved. So great. Yeah. I'm like converted to tea now. I learned what a builder's is.
Builder's tea.
Yes.
How is that coming up in conversation? What builder's tea? Did you like it?
Someone asked me, like, oh, you want a builder's? I was like, yeah, I do want to build. I had no idea
what it was. That's quite like a strong tea.
Yeah.
As teas go.
Yeah, I need that though.
That's your vibe.
The LA jet lag, I need a really strong one.
For sure. Did you have like little finger sandwiches then?
Yes, little cucumber sandwiches.
You've done it right.
Very fancy. Yeah.
Okay, cool. High tea. That's obviously way too sophisticated for me. I don't know it as that. So it's an education for me as well, despite actually living here. I also saw you did, and again, despite living here, never done this, the Abbey Road crossing.
Oh my gosh, yeah, I did that the other day. It was so fun. I mean, obviously.
It's just crossing a road, isn't it?
I mean, yeah, but it's a very historical road.
Yeah.
I don't know. I felt bad though. I feel like all the people in the cars that are like passing through Abbey Road are like, oh my God, the tourists again. Like,
They should know to not go down that road.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
going to happen.
That's why I didn't feel that bad, but a little bad.
Well, you mentioned the football game.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a little bit controversial for some people.
But I
want to talk more about that because you went to go and see Chelsea play football. And
right.
I'm saying it's controversial because, you know, there's some hardcore football fans in the UK who support their own team very passionately.
Right.
Have you picked your side now?
I don't know if I have. Quite yet. I had so much fun at the game, though.
Yeah.
Everyone is so enthusiastic. Like, I've never been to a sports game where people were so into it. And, like, chanting all these songs.
Yes.
And, like, getting up out of their seats and cheering the whole time. It was so much fun. And I definitely want to go to another one.
Did you know what was going on?
You know, not particularly, but I learned throughout the game. And so now I feel like I have a better grasp at what's going on.
You mentioned the chants. Was there any particular chant that you remember? Because I've got a few that I could teach you, if not, about Chelsea.
Can you teach me one?
Yeah. So there's one about a Chelsea legend called Frank Lampard.
Okay.
And it goes like this. Super Frank. It's quite easy. Super Frank. So that's one. That's quite an easy one to get on board with. There's also a former striker. And actually, this is a tune. You'll know this song. Beatles. Hey Jude. Good one. And actually, as you know what? I think this is actually the easiest one to remember. Chelsea, Chelsea, Chelsea.
Yes.
You would have heard this one.
Yeah.
Already there. If you know that one, you're halfway there already.
That's the one that I know. I just wonder the logistics of those songs. Like, who is the first person in the crowd who starts singing it and gets everyone to, you know, sing along with them? Like, who writes that song? Like, who's the first person to think, like, Chelsea, Chelsea?
I don't know if there's any publishing with it. I just think it's like a spontaneous thing. But there has to be someone that starts it, which is what I always think about as well. Wasn't you then? You weren't starting it.
No. Right. Maybe next time. Now I know.
After
you played me these songs, now I can go in and start them.
Okay. Let's talk about some real music. No disrespect to those wonderful chants. You are ramping up to this new album, which is, I guess, what, less than a month away now.
I know. Crazy.
How are you mentally feeling? Are you ready for this?
Yeah. I'm actually so excited. I feel like I've been working on these songs for so long and, you know, going through all this stuff for a while. And so I think it's going to be really cathartic to finally, like, share it and have it out in the world.
Yeah, that's quite a scary feeling, though, right? Because you've lived with it for X amount of time.
Yeah.
And then it's like opinions and reviews.
And it's scary and freeing. I mean, it's like everyone says this. It sounds so cliche now, but really when you put something out, it becomes, you know, everyone else's and doesn't become yours anymore. So I don't know. I'm trying to keep that in mind.
For sure. Well, it's called Guts.
Yeah.
So with that in mind, we've taken the title. We've gone, how can we make this into a game? And we have the Gutometer.
Ooh.
We want to test how gutsy you really are. There's five levels of questions. Each one is going to get more and more difficult. Every time you answer, we'll move on to the next. Here's the twist though, right? If you don't answer one of the questions, we cut time off your song Vampire.
Oh my God.
So if you want the full,
high stakes.
If you want the full thing, you need to answer all these questions and get gutsy with it, okay?
Okay, all right.
All right, it is high stakes, but are you feeling up for it?
Yeah, I'm a little nervous, but I'm up for it.
Okay, Olivia Rodrigo, how gutsy are you? Round one. Okay, let's set the tension here. When was the last time you, Olivia, got home at sunrise?
Ooh. I mean, honestly, this isn't a very scandalous answer or anything, but actually filming the Bad Idea Right music video, we filmed until 5 in the morning. I filmed from like 9 a.m. one day and then we went to 5 a.m. the next day and I was a zombie, but I got home when it was light out.
I knew it would be the music video answer.
Sorry.
I wish I was more
exciting.
It's level one. It's fine. Let's move on. Round two. What's the one secret about the new album that you've not told anyone? Anyone.
That I wrote all the songs about you.
Oh, wow. It's a good one. I'm flustered. Round three. We're through to round three. What's your toxic trait?
I lose everything. I lose my phone every 5 seconds and it annoys everyone around me. If I go to the airport, like, I'll always leave my passport at home.
Yeah.
Like, bad stuff like that. Like,
okay.
I guess that's not the worst thing ever, but.
So toxic.
So toxic.
You know what I hate about Olivia? She always loses her phone. It drives me crazy. It's so toxic. Okay, we're up to 2 minutes of Vampire so far. Let's see if we can get another 30 seconds out of you. Readers, if you'd be so kind and gutsy, the last DM that you sent to someone.
Oh, I don't have my phone on me. Should I get it?
Yeah.
Can someone
grab
it?
Well, if you want another 30 seconds of Vampire to play. I will just sit here listening to this whilst it plays out.
I want to hear yours. Can we do a tradesy?
All right. You want to hear my class?
Yeah. Okay. It's only fair.
Jeez, this is going to be scary.
Oh, I'm actually really scared. I don't know what mine is.
Okay, what's mine? Okay. The last DM do you know Sam Fisher? He's a singer. The city's gonna break.
Yes.
I can't read out the message. It was swearing.
Oh,
it was
swearing. No.
I was sending a sweary message.
I mean.
Don't scroll. Just scroll. You're scrolling
just,
down.
Okay, I was fine. Whatever. My best friend Conan texted me a picture of this guy that I think is cute, and I said, "Oh wow, he's everything."
Does he know who I am?
Round five. Yeah, there's a picture of you.
This is good going, by the way. Level five.
Okay, how many minutes are we at? Or how many seconds?
I think we're 2 minutes, 30 seconds.
Oof, it's a long song.
Whew. Can you play us a snippet of one of your new songs?
Oh.
And a snippet could be 5 seconds. It could be 0.3. But just a snippet.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You feeling gutsy?
Okay.
You're up for it?
Scared.
Okay, here we go.
That's how you get.
Sounding good to me. Sounding good to me.
Shortest snippet in all of history.
We'll take it. You have earned the full play. When we said you were coming on the show, UK fans are like, oh my God, can I speak to Olivia? We've got so many questions. I don't know why they necessarily sound like that, but that's how I imagine it. Nick, good one. When are we going to get a UK tour? That must be happening with an album coming out.
Yeah. I mean, it's all in the works. I can't like say anything yet, but I'm so excited to play all these songs in a live show. I think it's going to be super fun.
Okay. Melissa said, what should we be most excited for ahead of the new album?
Ooh. I mean, I think there's just like a lot of fun songs. I like kind of wrote this album with the tour in mind, so I think they're all kind of songs that I wanted people to be able to scream in a crowd. So hopefully
Wicked.
That's what is achieved.
Good one from Joe here. Please tell Olivia how much Bad Idea Right connected with me. It wasn't a question, it's more just a statement.
Oh.
That is an amazing new song.
Thank you.
It's really, 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 really cool.
It's a fun one.
It's been out, I guess, a week now. This is a question for me now. Was that a series of events that inspired that? Was it a particular person? Was it a few things?
Yeah, I actually sent a text that said, seeing you tonight is a bad idea, right? To someone. And
knowing the answer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Obviously, rhetorical. Yeah. But I looked at the text and I was like, wow, that rhymes. Like, my little songwriter brain was like, noted. And so,
screenshot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The next time we were in the studio, my producer was kind of making fun of me and I was telling him about the situation and he goes, my brain goes, and I was like, ha, lol, funny. And then we were like, wait, there might be something there. And then we wrote the song.
Sick. It's so clever. It's so clever.